Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to turn your HTML, CSS, and JavaScript skills into fully functional desktop applications using Python and PyWebView. Now, this is just a small app, just to teach you how to use it. But for real example, I create my main app of background remover with HTML, CSS, JavaScript. And here is result, it's better styling and better design than using Python. You have also can use JavaScript for your project. Maybe you have JavaScript knowledge better than Python, like for example, using threeges and all other library of JavaScript. This is 10 times better than old Python style that I showed you in previous video. If you've been wanting to create desktop apps, but didn't want to learn complex GUI frameworks like Tinter or Qt, this tutorial is perfect for you. We'll take a simple web interface and transform it into a native desktop application that you can distribute as a standalone executable file. By the end of this video, you'll understand exactly how PyWebView works, how to set up the communication between Python and JavaScript, and how to package everything into a professional desktop application. To get started, you need Python installed on your system. I recommend Python 3.8 or newer. Open your terminal or command prompt and install PyWebView. Pip install PyWebView. That's it for development. PyWebView will automatically use the best web engine available on your system. Edge WebView 2 on Windows, WebKit on Mac, or WebKit GTK on Linux. To run your application during development, simply navigate to your project folder and run Python app.py. Your desktop application will launch just like any native program. So now, let me explain codes. What exactly is PyWebView? Think of it as a bridge that connects the web world with desktop applications. PyWebView creates a native window on your operating system, whether you're on Windows, Mac, or Linux, and displays your HTML content inside it. But here's what makes it special. It's not just a static web page viewer. You get full bidirectional communication between your Python backend and your JavaScript frontend. This means you can use Python for all the heavy lifting, file operations, database connections, API calls, complex calculations. We have just 4 files, and that's all we need. This is our Python backend that creates the desktop window and handles all the Python logic. Index.html, style.css, script.js, JavaScript that communicates with our Python backend. This is where all the magic happens. First, we import the necessary modules. Import WebView. Import threading. Import time. Import OS. Import sys. The WebView import is our main PyWebView library. We use threading for background operations, time for delays, and OS and sys for file path handling. Next, we have the API class. This is the bridge between Python and JavaScript. Class API. This class contains all the functions that your JavaScript code can call. Think of it as your backend API, but instead of HTTP requests, JavaScript calls these functions directly. The resource underscore path function is crucial for making your app work both during development and when compiled to an executable. Def resource underscore path, relative underscore path, try, base underscore path equals sys underscore mypass. Accept exception. Return os.path.join, base underscore path, relative underscore path. When you run your Python script normally, it uses the current directory. But when PyInstaller creates an executable, it extracts files to a temporary folder. This function handles both scenarios automatically. Finally, the main function creates your desktop application. Def main, HTML underscore file underscore path equals resource underscore path, index.html, webview.start, debug equals false. WebView.create underscore window is where you configure your desktop window. You can set the title, minimum size, and most importantly, connect your API class with JS underscore API equals API. This makes all your Python functions available to JavaScript. The WebView.start call launches your application. Setting debug equals false is important for production builds. Let's look at how the JavaScript side works. In your script.js file, async function call Python. Const response equals await PyWebView.api document.getElementById message.innerText equals response. The magic object here is PyWebView.api. This gives you access to any function you defined in your Python API class. Notice we use async/await because these calls are asynchronous. The PyWebViewReady event ensures everything is connected before communication starts. Window.addEventListener, PyWebViewReady, function. This creates a robust communication system where both sides know when they're ready to talk to each other. Turning your application into a standalone executable that you can share with anyone, even if they don't have Python installed. First, install pyinstaller. Pip install pyinstaller. Then, navigate to your project folder in the terminal and run this command. Pyinstaller, one file, windowed, add data, index.html, add data, style.css, add data, script.js. Let me break down what each part does. One file creates a single executable file instead of a folder with multiple files. Windowed hides the console window so your app looks professional. No black terminal window. Add data is source destination. The dot means put in the root of the executable. After pyinstaller finishes, it might take a few minutes. You'll find your executable in the dist folder. This single file contains everything: Python runtime, your code, PyWebView, and all your web files. You can copy this file to any computer and it will run without requiring Python to be installed. And that's how you build professional desktop applications using Python and web technologies. If you found this tutorial helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more Python and web development content. Drop a comment below and let me know what kind of desktop application you're planning to build. I'd love to hear your ideas. The complete source code for this project is available in the description below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.